Hey everyone, Grzegorz Baran here. This is going to be a very short video. Please let me know if you believe I should cover this subject a bit better, but also if you like this shorter form and would like to see more videos of this type on my channel. Basically, almost every single seamless material repeats itself when presented in separation, and it's totally fine. Material can be considered as well made if the repetition is well balanced and is not very obvious when tiled at least three times. Only very uniform materials without too much altering don't look repetitive. But even these, when repeated dozens of times, still might look repetitive. Recently, I scanned a dirt surface covered with some grass scraps and turned it into three separate materials. One with original coverage of grass scraps and some leafy plants, one with grass scraps without leafy plants, and one without any plants at all, with just dirt on it. Even after I did my best to get rid of the most obvious repetition, each of these is still repetitive to some degree, and that's totally fine, because some level of material repetition gives material the altering it needs to look authentic, and simply shouldn't be removed. It's all about proper balance. When making a material, we should remove edge seams and just obvious, very distinctive repetition. And we should deal with subtle repetition in CG rendering system in totally different way, by introducing other elements. For example, by blending two different materials together. So, if we create a plane with 20 by 20 meters coverage and apply this material with its original 2 by 2 meters coverage to this plane and tile it 10 times to match the original coverage with physical surface coverage, we can clearly see that material repeats itself and has dark and bright repetitive patches across. What we need to do is to apply another well-made material to it and mix both together the way the repetition is gone. This blending can be driven by additional mask or by vertex color. This exact example was made in Blender using vertex color and vertex painting, and as you can see, the repetition is gone. Not to mention that nothing stops us to blend even more materials together and make the surface even more interesting and even less repetitive. And basically that's it. We can break this repetition even more with props or decals, but I guess that would be a subject for a different video. Please let me know if you want me to create another, more in-depth video to show how exactly I build this shader setup in Blender, and bear in mind that even if presented in Blender, this actual approach applies to any CG rendering system and is commonly used around. This way we can get high surface quality and decent altering when seen from close distance, but also lack of repetition. Anyway, I really hope you found this shorter form useful. If you like it, please drop a comment, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Big thanks to all of you who did it already. See you next time. Bye!